Welcome back. From Gabby Petito to Daniel Robinson, missing persons cases are in the spotlight now and in the headlines, both nationally and locally.
There's a Valley-based nonprofit working both of those investigations, and they have a mission to give families some answers and hopefully some peace of mind. Whitney Clark spoke with the founder of the group and is joining us in the newsroom with this story. Whitney?
Jared and Yetta is called the Find Me Group and was founded in 2002 by a former DEA agent who spent more than 20 years in law enforcement. He also worked with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children and created a sort of network of experts as a proactive way to approach these missing persons cases.
Kelly Snyder is technically retired, cutting down his usual 10-hour workdays.
Currently sitting on 42 investigations that I haven't even assigned yet.
Out of his Chandler home, he's answering emails and taking calls for the Find Me group.
Out of the 358 cases that we've worked, we've located 111 people.
From psychics to search and rescue dogs, private investigators and medical examiners, police departments and families directly reach out to the nonprofit that can be on the ground investigating all across the country.
Sometimes we'll get a request immediately when the police are called. We'll get it within a day or two or a week. But most of the time, it's usually within a month or two when the family realizes that the police are not looking for their missing loved one, whether it's an adult or a child.
As a father and grandfather, one of the cases that hit home was the search for Isabel Celis. The tragic disappearance of the 6-year-old girl in Tucson led to a massive search effort. Her body was found in 2017. Snyder says the team only works 3 or 4 cases a month, focusing on each one at a time.
Sometimes we get a case that's 10, 15 years old, and the circumstances don't change. It just makes it harder and a less possibility of finding that individual the longer the people wait.
Snyder says they don't want to give families false hope, but to some degree, the group is a last resort. Filling in a gap, volunteers are always training for.
Well, Kelly says what they do need is volunteers, and there is some training involved. We will have a link for those who may want to participate up on our website. That's azfamily.com. Yetta.